Very good morning and most welcome to all of you on Hahnemann's 266th birthday, 10th April 2020. You all know, as a whole, the world is now in very great crisis due to COVID-19, and any organization and any institute in the world not in a position to make any gathering. But 10th April is something special date to all homeopathic fraternity to pay our tribute. The Bengal Academy of Applied Homeopathy, Kolkata, West Bengal, India, like to present a topic entitled as Hahnemann as a Man. You might have a question in your mind. We all know Hahnemann was a man, but why this topic has been selected? When I have gone through the life and works of Hahnemann by Richard Hell, there is a beautiful line, quote, "Hahnemann the physician is inseparable from Hahnemann the man, both are one," unquote. Just from this line, I got the inspiration to select the topic. Before going to the main topic, I'd like to present some pictures, holy places. This is the birthplace, Hahnemann's birthplace in Germany. The name of the place is Meissen. It is about 12 miles northwest from the city of Dresden, beside a little river named Missy. In this town where Hahnemann took birth, this is the holy place, this is the holy house, three-storied building, where Hahnemann took birth. And it was written in book, one of the room adjacent to road in ground floor, our master took his birth about 266 years ago, in the year 1755, 10th April. Regarding his own birth, our master told, "I was born April 10, 1755, in the Electorate of Saxony, one of the most beautiful parts of Germany." Now I am sharing a beautiful information, how he was blessed in his childhood. In one occasion, his father told to his fellow men, "I must go home now. I have to give a lesson to my son Samuel, a lesson in thinking. That boy must learn to think." Perhaps when a father thinks in that line, "I do like to learn my son or daughter a lesson to thinking," then only the outcome would be a man like Samuel Hahnemann. When Hahnemann was matured, in his mature days, he wrote a beautiful line about his father. "My father had the soundest idea of what can be called good and worthy for mankind." I am repeating, quote, "My father had the soundest idea of what can be called good and worthy for mankind. Act and be yourself without simulation. Impressed upon me more by his example than by his words," unquote, Hahnemann. And after a few days, he left his birthplace and for education, he had to stay at Leipzig for a few years. This is the room where our master lived in Leipzig, didn't time. But at Leipzig, there is a beautiful medical school, and as he was having attitude in medical science, he began his student life in Leipzig, attending lectures, but next he moved to Vienna. It is a picture where Hahnemann learned his knowledge about medical science at Vienna. Hahnemann wrote, quote, "My fondness for practicing medicine, as there is no medical school at Leipzig, let me go to Vienna at my own expense," unquote. Now I am moving forwards. It is the first page of the book written by William Collins. It is known that Hahnemann at this period of his life practiced medicine for a time in several towns, and when he was translating a book, Materia Medica by William Collins, on page number 114, volume 2, he got the line what was well known to all of you in the chapter of Cinquina. Now I am going to the main topic, Hahnemann as a man. First of all, Hahnemann's physiognomy. If we minutely observe the pictures, portraits of Hahnemann, whatever we are getting, it contains all the indications of a remarkable and self-confident intelligence and unbending will through his expression. His physiognomy itself describes his personality. Afterwards, whenever he was writing his epoch-making book, Chronic Disease, in the year 1827 to 28, in that time, Hahnemann wrote a letter to Dr. Staff. Quote, "The translation from the Chinese into German of Confucius' work by Scott is very desirable. It conveys to the reader divine wisdom without miracles, fables, or superstition. It is an important sign of the times that Confucius can now be read in our country. I shall soon embrace him in the realm of happy spirits. These benefactors of men who showed us the straight path to wisdom and to God 6.5 centuries before the arch visionary," unquote. You just see, whenever he was writing theory of chronic disease, at the same time, he was how voracious learner. At the same time, he was reading Confucius writings. "I shall soon embrace him in the realm of happy spirits, this benefactor of man who showed us straight path to wisdom and to God." Regarding political attitude, in Hahnemann's lives and works, it was written clearly, Hahnemann really lacked in one thing. What was that? Hahnemann really lacked in his nature was an interest for politics. He had no interest for politics, but personal interest for the general social economics of the countrymen. Next, we are going about his spirituality. He was writing a letter Is there any greater happiness than to do good? Even when we have departed hence, the great, the only, the infinite being who promoted the happiness of all creatures will show us how to come nearer to his perfection and blessedness by further acts of beneficence, and how to become more like to him through all eternity. He was so dedicated. He was telling, when we have departed hence, the great, the only, the infinite being who promoted the happiness of all creatures will show us how to come nearer to his perfection and blessedness by further acts of beneficence, and how to become more like to him through all eternity. It was written in the year 1828 on 10th April. Now I am sharing a letter of Hahnemann from one of his patients. As we are now in home, we are staying at home due to lockdown, some of us feeling bored and not time is not passing properly. What Hahnemann wrote in the year 1830 to his patient: distribute your hours carefully. What he wrote? We have to distribute our hours carefully. Every lost hour is an irreparable loss, which a sensitive conscience can never quite forgive. Regarding lost hour, he also told, the hour not employed to our best advantage and to that of others. There is nothing that we must watch over and restrain more than our physical inclination, including that of imagination. He suggested to the patients to restrain physical and mental inclinations and imaginations. Then he wrote, the animal part of us requires constant supervision. What is the animal part of us? He clearly noted. Physical inclination and imagination without reasoning. He told, the animal part of us requires constant supervision, as strict and unremitting control as our power of reason possesses. It is only through constant victory that we are made happy through this salutary and lofty consciousness. We feel then that we are resting in the friendship of the only one. He was suggesting to his patients how a man would be a friend of Almighty, and clearly suggested, restrain yourself from physical inclination and imagination that are having no reason. In the year 1827, when almost the theory of chronic disease was ready to publish, he read to staff, sorry, I acknowledge with sincere thankfulness the infinite mercy of the one great giver of all good for having preserved me hitherto in strength and cheerful spirits, and amidst all the assaults of my enemies. So to fight with the assault of enemies, we have to acquire strength and cheerfulness from the great giver. And he wrote, I have no other wish left than to lay before the world in a worthy manner the good which the Supreme Being has permitted me to discover. What he discovered? He discovered theory of chronic disease. Or I may say, revealed to me. First he was telling, I discovered theory of chronic disease. Then himself, he corrected, I may say, it was revealed to me. For what? For the alleviation of the sufferings of mankind. Then I am ready to depart this life. Regarding philosophy as the foundation of knowledge, Hahnemann wrote, quote, philosophy represents the highest ideal towards the human mind, is imbued with the desire to struggle. If we like to struggle, our life is to be imbued or is to be reached, enriched with philosophy. Philosophy is not only the highest of all sciences, it is also the basis and the fundamental of others. Without philosophy, science falls to the level of subsidiary subject. This is true above all medicine. Today's discussion, I do like to conclude with a beautiful assertion from our master. Master's call to us. What he told? Quote, physicians are my brothers on earth. Whatever he did was nothing but his duty towards God, of whom he awaited the most gracious gratitude and rewards in the beyond. So, we the homeopathic physicians are the brothers of our master. He embraced like that and he told us, whatever we are doing, just we are doing our duty towards God. So, I am happy to conclude with these words. Hahnemann as a man is the same as Hahnemann as a physician. Both are one. One whole and complete personality. Such as may not easily recur in the history of world. Not only in the history of medicine, in the history of world. I pay my cordial respect and tribute from core of the heart to our master and pray to him to bless all homeopathic fraternity throughout the world to be, to do something better for homeopathy, for mankind. Thank all of you for your patient sharing. Namaskar.